AM Daily, web worldwide.
Yo, what's up? What's up? Let's keep it real, son. Count this money, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, yo, put the brands over there in the safe, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, spinning these Jacksons. The Washingtons go to wifey, you know how that go.
I'm saying that's what this is all about, right?
So, Dallas, what are the most slept on Jordans from 1 through 15 and the most slept on foams? Foamposite 1s and Foamposite Pros.
Well, okay, most slept on Jordan 1 through 15, that's easy, it's gonna be 15. I feel like 1 through 14 is not slept on whatsoever. And 1 through 14 releases and retro releases, I feel like always get the proper coverage and hype behind them. 14s, I mean, as you work your way down, 14, 13, 12, boom, 11, okay, 11 is always, that holiday release is always stupid, all right? These 11 low releases this year, 2015, have all been hyped, have all had tremendous responses to it. The nine is an odd shooting me in the Jordan pantheon, simply because he was playing baseball when the nine was released.
That's correct, that's
so
correct.
He doesn't have any NBA history with the nine, but it falls in the range from 1 to 14, so the nine gets major hype too. In my opinion, the Jordan 2 is honestly the real, that's really where the myth begins.
Sure.
And it was with the build of that shoe, that original release, the Italian leather. Like, this was a luxury, this was a shoe on the level of a Bally or a Gucci shoe made by a sneaker company. So it was really dope boy swag available to the masses. And the Jordan 2, man, people were like getting yoked up, you know, beat over the head. It was really going down if you had a pair of Jordan 2s, and you better have your knuckle game right. And even then, you better be rolling deep, because kids will definitely try to put the butt on them, you know what I mean? Just for a pair of Jordan 2s.
Mm. All right.
If you ask me what the most slept on Jordan is through the Jordan program right now from 1 to 29, I mean, certainly the later models, 29s, 28s, that 28 SE, man, I like. But I feel like the 2009 is one of the most comfortable Jordan performance shoes I've ever worn. Beautiful lockdown feel, great feel to just chill in. And I slept on it. I bought a bunch of pairs out of Marshalls. and they were $50. They were $49.99. And the retail box of the shoe was $190. All right, so the Marshalls had them, and they were having them $49.99. I bought a gang of them, and I love the shoe. I love the 2009. But slept on Jordans 1 to 15. 15. Slept on Foamposites. Between Foamposites and Foamposite Pros. Oh man, I gotta tell you something. The Foamposite hype has just been non-stop over the last several years. I'm loving the Asteroid Foam Pro. Matter of fact, I bought two pairs of them. I got two pairs, one to rock, one to stop. And I don't even really watch the Foam Pros to tell. I got a handful of Foam Pros. I got the green camo Foam Pro. Matter of fact, I got two pairs of Foam Pros. Two different colors, the green camo, and I got two pairs of the Asteroid. Those are the only foam pros I own. Those are the fire foam pros. And I mean, foam ones, none of them are really slept on, man. It's just a hot shoe, clean shoe. I like the foam, but I don't want that swoosh disturbing that foam upper. I just love to look at that upper and really enjoy it. So foam pros are ones they're not slept on. I mean, you know, some places might still have a pair around, but in general, people cop those at first release.